issues, technical issues. Hey, there we go. Hi, everybody. Welcome to my dining room table. It's lunchtime, so I'm eating. Oh, no. Where is it? Where's the camera? There it is. Oh, I just dropped it. Wow. Wow, y'all.
Classic.
Thought I had everything I needed. I did not have a paper towel in case I dripped potato salad juice on my artwork. Whoops. Anyway, welcome to my kitchen table. Welcome to my potato salad juice. Let me do this too. There we go. That was dumb. So hi. Let's get started. A couple weeks ago, we found this thing in the shed. And it is not... let's be brutally honest. It's butt ugly. Butt ugly. Oh, there's my potato chunk. Yeah, I ate that. Anyway, it was just like stone colored. So I immediately spray painted it white. And I've tried to do like an ombre situation with blue on the top. It only did one little glob. I don't think you can see it, but there's one little glob of blue. My blue spray paint was too old. But I did manage to get a little ombre green situation on the bottom. And then I was like, I gotta paint the rest. Cause I don't know, it was just calling to me. Yeah. I want it very pastel. Oh my God, so sorry I'm chewing, that's gross. And this was like a real journey because I could not find my paints. My whole goal was to not spend any money on this thing because I just found it in the shed and it was ugly and I was like, I can make this better. But I couldn't find my paint. So I had to buy new paint, which sucks. I'm also using 50 cent craft paint. So it's not like I was working real hard at this. Anyway, I don't like that purple color, so I'm mixing a new purple. It's too light. I don't like purple in general. Oh my God, why would this happen? Oh, there. Oh. Do you ever have this happen? Like, okay, cool, neat. Thanks. Shrink wrap. I hate shrink wrap. I'm just gonna. More technical difficulties. I just want to make art. Oh my God, this is neon. This is real pink. Cheesy chums. Watch me cut my finger off live on Twitch. That would be fun. No, that's not gonna happen. There we go. This pink is a little too neon. I don't know if you can tell. Ooh, she's blowing a bubble. Let's see what happens here. Anyway, I showed Instagram a little sneak peek of what I wanted this roof to look like. I think we're gonna need a bigger blue. And with a little bit of ideas for what color this house should be, and overwhelmingly everyone said purple, and that's like really what my guts were saying, so I'm glad my instinct was right. This color is already much better than what's going on now. Way, way, way better. There we go. It's pastel-y enough, but this one that I have now is just too light. Oh, yeah! I also painted the insides of these little birdhouses, or those two, with that bright purple. I think I'm gonna keep it there. But yeah, this has been a really fun project to work on. just, you know, when I feel like being creative. I love painting stuff, but I don't like coming up with the idea. Like, start to finish painting something? No way, that does not sound fun. At least like a canvas. But something like a flower pot, or this thing, which is already sculpted. I just have to kind of fill in the spots. And as you can see, I'm not being precious with it. Like, if I mess up, I can always paint that spot again. Again, since I think this thing is butt ugly, the whole process is very low pressure, so I enjoy that. Oh my god, can you see? Is my head bonking? Welcome to my ponytail. Sorry about that. That's fine for me. Yeah. How y'all doing? What's up? There's one person watching. Thank you for watching. Preesh. I have a laptop in front of me so I can read the chat. If there is a chat, it probably won't be a chat. I'm not gonna lie. No one wants to chat with me. Who cares? Who am I? Before I started doing this, I was watching a lady do one of those diamond paintings that I don't know if y'all get nonstop ads for on Instagram, but I sure do. And again, find them mostly butt ugly. Like, most of the designs suck. And they're expensive. So I don't get it, but it does seem like a very soothing task to just place those gems. Again, gem placing, not my favorite. Not my favorite thing. All right, I really like that color. It looks good. So I'm trying to get this to have some sort of a, I don't know what the word is. I guess it's an ombre kind of a vibe. Really, it's just light and dark shadows. I'm trying to make it look like it has dimension. So this one is, you can see all the boards are a different color. Did I open the right paint? Bright blue. Oh, I think I meant to open bright blue. Whoa. Can y'all see me mix paint? Because I feel like that's the other interesting part. Here we go. Oh yeah. Perfect. So yeah, I'm not doing a bunch of totally different colors, but I don't know, I just want it to have a little bit of dimension. You can't even notice that, honestly. And as I do this, I'm noticing there's a spot I'm gonna see that I didn't get filled in. And I just totally destroyed that color, so whoops, guess it's just not filled in forever. No, not true. I can probably find a little dollop. I realize I'm in front of the camera. I'm so sorry. That's so mean. I'm actually gonna take this darker color in between the fences. That's pickets. Because wouldn't it be a bit darker back there? I don't know. I feel like it might. I also just did a really dumb thing because I've learned from doing other layers that it's best to work right to left because I am right-handed. So now I'm gonna stick my, I guarantee, watch me lay my hand in this at least two or three times. It's happened before, that's why I know. All right, I have this teeny, teeny, tiny brush that I used to use for nail art. Can you even see that? It's just like from the art supply store, but I cut it down. Let's see if I can get a smidge of that old color. I don't do nails anymore, so I am just repurposing this brush. Oh my god, duh, I just painted that the other color. Whoops! Where was my spot? Ah, there it is. But yeah, I'm repurposing my old nail art brushes just to get in like the tiny spots. Again, I don't super care if it's perfect. my end plan with this is to just hit it with some clear spray and put it in the yard. That's where it belongs, I think, is in the yard. So if it's not perfect, I mean, it's gonna get destroyed by weather eventually, so I'm not too tied, not too emotionally tied to this. That deserves a potato bite. Okay. Just checking to make sure there's no more purple bits that I haven't done. I think we're good. Cool. So speaking of this house, I kind of want to change the color. I'm not super in love with it. I might save that. I'm gonna go rinse my brushes real quick and I'll be back. Next we're gonna do, I don't know. It's supposed to work that way. So let's do this roof. Let's do that roof. Okay, BRB. And I'm back. Still ain't nobody chatting. That's fine. I'm by myself. I don't need to talk. Again, thanks to the one person who's watching. Earlier I mentioned that this took a while because I couldn't find my paint. And I had... God, the more I look at that house, the more... Yeah, I'm gonna redo it. It took a while because I had to rebuy all my paint, and you know, we're kind of like in a pandemic right now, so it's not like I'm leaving the house to go buy crappy craft paint, you know? I'm gonna mix a tiny bit of this insane neon. So that's why I have this freaking nuts neon pink. I would never buy this. I mean, I don't hate it, but it's just not what I was going for this project. I think we can get something. Oh yeah. That is that Pepto pink I was looking for. So the lighter pink is too blue for me, and that other one is too neon, but this is perfect. So I am gonna repaint this house. Haha, watch me hide and watch. Oh, that's already so much better. Pa-cha! Didn't I tell you I would lay my hand in that? Luckily it's dry. I didn't mess it up. Wow. I just got real lucky. So yeah, that's part of why it's done in stages. I'm not doing the whole thing at once because I will screw it up. I will lay my hand in some wet paint and screw it up. So, taking my sweet time with this. But yeah, I'm thankful that we live in a society where, you know, we can be in a pandemic and I don't have to leave the house. That's pretty cool. And I'm just really confused why other people are not excited about that. Like, they're not really doing it, you know? Like, I have an autoimmune disease, and so does my husband. And I don't know, just like... I think really hard before each situation, is this worth it? And so far, like, really, nothing has been worth it in terms of leaving the house. But I know people who are like going on road trips, going to restaurants openly, flagrantly dining at restaurants, kissing people on the mouth. I would love to hug my friends. Like, I have a friend who's, we just found out she's moving away, and that's really sad. We love her a lot. We're not gonna get to hug her goodbye. Oh my god, I did it again. So yeah, I feel like some of us are doing the thing and making the sacrifice, and other people are just like being very selfish, and that's a bummer. And it's to the extent where I had to quit my job because I was working in non-essential retail, luxury retail, and we were on break for a long time. But I went back for my first shift, and I couldn't do it. I had a panic attack. It was too scary. So I know some people think this is like a hoax or whatever. I think over 100,000 dead people is not a hoax. And I don't want to be one of those dead people. And I certainly don't want my dude to be one of those dead people. Or any of my coworkers. So that's why I quit. I could not be around them. Because I couldn't trust them. I'm repainting this bird too, by the way. I couldn't trust the people I work with. I couldn't trust the people who think it's okay to go shopping for luxury goods at this point in time. And I wouldn't have been able to serve them kindly. So I had to just bow out. And that was not an easy choice. I mean, it kind of was and it kind of wasn't. Like, it's scary as hell. I don't have a new job. I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I'm not gonna die of coronavirus because of my job. I refuse. Also, I'm not sure if y'all realize, but there's like kind of a class war / social justice uprising going on right now. And I'm on the side of the people. So I couldn't keep putting money in a rich family's pocket. I just couldn't. So can't work retail anymore. Done. Kind of glad that portion of my life is over. It's the third time I've repainted those birds, by the way. I think they're finally to a pink that I like. We'll see how it dries. We'll see how that looks when it dries. Okay, so I'm gonna darken up that color, ombre it. I'm thinking another glob of that pink because that looked so good. So let's do a teeny tiny bit. It's getting a little neon, but that's okay. I'm actually gonna mix all of it together, and we're gonna use red, or that color might be good enough on its own. We'll see. How different is it? Not different at all. Okay, I'm gonna open up red. I have this gloss red that I've been using. Again, when you're buying things online, you don't always get what you want. And I definitely did not order gloss, or maybe they were sold out of regular. I don't remember, but I had to rebuy red. All right, let's try this again. Tiniest glob of red. Boop. Nope, that's okay. I like that. I actually really like that. Okay. I think that's how this got so... it's too orangey for me. There we go. Oh, hell yeah. And I don't mind that. It's just not what I wanted for that area. And also, this roof is going to be orange. Cool. So I didn't want a too orangey pink right there, if that makes any sense. Cool, so now I'm just gonna paint over that. I feel like I should repaint that one, but I think I'm gonna leave it darker, even though that makes no sense perspective-wise. Like, that one should be lighter and that one should be darker because that is in the background, that is in the foreground. So let me just think that through as I do this one side. Last time I was listening to the radio while I was streaming, I got a copyright strike because they played a Beatles song. Which is hilarious because, like, whoops. I didn't put that on. I didn't do it. But I get it. So hopefully that doesn't happen again. I tried to take the audio out. I don't know. I'm doing all of my streaming through my phone. And my dude's borrowed Chromebook, so it's not like I have the best like editing capabilities. I have like zero editing capabilities. I did just download iMovie though, so that's cool. I can do that eventually. And also, this stream is brought to you by my bestie, who bought me the phone grabber / ring light that is holding my phone right now. So thanks to her, because I was about to just tape my phone to the camera tripod that we have.
I don't know how to do that.
And I think she was like, sheesh, dude, just do it. Okay, I'm gonna kind of leave the insides that older color, so it's darker. It's looking a lot better. It's still looking, what's the word I'm looking for? It's not the right ombre, but that's okay. I can make it a smidge lighter over here. If you can see, but I'm being kind of sloppy because I'm not too concerned, but also since I'm doing multiple layers, I feel like I can go back and adjust at the very end, which might be a fool's error because as you can see, I'm like mixing each color for the thing. All right, I'm just gonna give it a lift so I can take a peek. I'm not mad at that. We need to change these ones though. Those are not good. That's is it more red? Yeah. That's too similar. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna open up this other red. I'm wondering if it's the gloss that's giving it that weird, like, peachy orange tone. Oh, that one worked much better. Pretty similar. It's a little too similar. Shucks. Well, how about... Oh, already had some fun. Sure, if if it's obvious, but I actually really hate mixing my own colors. I wish I just had a rainbow of everything available to me. I did not have to work for it, but oh well. I think I'm going to leave that side kind of darker. I don't know. It's looking a little patchy, actually, compared, because it's only one coat. I'll probably just go do the whole thing again. Ponytail in the shot? No. To give it a little lifty lift just to make sure I can see it from all sides every now and then.
Yeah, don't hate that.
Not at all. Okay. I'm gonna do just a little bit more red. Good. There's kind of no way to know until I just do it, which stinks, because if I don't want to, I just ruined it. No. Hey. This is why I don't like mixing my own colors, because I'm not very good at it. I get scared of doing too much, and so I do too little, and they look exactly the same, and then I end up having to paint the same spot more than once, so that's irritating, but whatever.
I feel like I should have just left it.
Shoot! Oh well. No going back now, so let's just make this way more red. Whoop. I don't have enough paint, so I keep grabbing the lighter color, and I know that's what's messing me up. just go ahead and get a little red. Mix that whole red glob in. Oh my god, it's perfect already. See, that was easy. Note to self, don't be a wimp. Just mix. Just mix it up. Oh my god, yeah. Also, I really should be mixing this with something other than the brush I'm using, because my brush is getting too painty. That's an issue. There we go, there we go. Again, thanks to that one person watching. Hope this is soothing to you. Percent of this stream is me swirling paint around that you can't even see, it's off camera. On my grocery ad that I'm using as a table here. This is some real like seat of your pants art situation. I'm not like, I don't have a studio. I have a dining room table and a phone on a tripod. And I don't like cleaning, so I used an old piece of paper as my palette, old newsprint grocery advertisement. Yeah, it's okay. Just like straight up red on the side. Wow, what was I thinking? Moral of the story is you don't need a lot to make art. Use what you got. I'm not going to repaint that one, by the way. I decided that. I think they look just fine together. Realize that I'm in the light. I'm in my own light. There we go. So I'm getting kind of shaky. I'll eat a couple potatoes. It's dry enough yet. I don't think that's dry enough. Speaking of dry, I'm gonna go rinse my brushes. Debating on what I should do next, I think, is roof. I can't remember what color I want. Oh, I do. BRB. Bob Ross, I'd have like a stick that I could be whacking my brush against, but. Does this look like public television to you? Hmm. Okay. Ooh. So let's see, that should go light to dark. We're gonna do. Oh man. I thought I had a hard time opening that paint when my hands were dry. Here we go. Oh my. Really glad I have a box cutter there. Was not. Did not plan that. Okay. Let's see what this sucker looks like. Get light to dark. We're gonna start on the bottom. Ooh. She's cute. Let's do that right there. It's really close to the fence color. To come around to the side for this one. There we go. I'm really not trying to get paint on this area, so. Well, I said that I am not being very careful. Survey says that's a lie. Because I don't want any on the green or the white. Except for this part, I'm gonna have to lift. Getting in there. This used to have a color. Again, it was just kind of like stone. Very boring. Very ugly. I mean, I don't think this thing is particularly attractive at all in general. This is not my style. But you know, found it in the shed. It was free. Might as well. Really sure. I kind of want to make that a darker blue. God, I like that so far. I'm not mad at it. Oh, yeah. I need a potato after that. Cute. Okay. I wanted it to get lighter as it goes up, so. Light blue. Mm-hmm. Shoot. Okay. I cannot believe I missed that. Oh, no, okay. It just felt kind of wet. It wasn't wet. I don't know why. To be clean, and I just got paint all over that lid. Oh well. Again, it's a 50-cent jar of acrylic paint. I'm not too concerned. Dude, that's cute. See that? This is what I have to get. There we go. Before I started painting this thing, I didn't clean it that great. I just kind of hosed it off and then spray painted it. So I get into those little teeny tiny areas and they're pretty grimy still. I mean, that's fine. Well, dirt never hurt anyone. Again, this is gonna live in the yard, so not too concerned, but not trying to add grime to the color scheme here. No dirt in the paint, please. And I'm just trying to get these underneath areas really good because I don't know that I'm gonna want to paint those again. Like, I'll put a second coat on the areas that you really see, the big flat spots that look kind of patchy, but these inside details, I'm not too concerned about. All right. I think that looks pretty good. Let's have another potato. Mm-hmm. Mm. All right. I love baby blue. It's like my favorite color. Has been for a long time. Oh, it's so good. Damn, that's a good one. Oh my god. Woo! Yes! Got probably shouldn't have turned that whole pile into light blue. I don't know if you can see from my older ones, I was pretty good at leaving spots of the other colors so I could grab some more, or at least like reference what they look like when they were wet. Clearly did not do that today, but you know, that's fine. It's cool. Oops. I love that so much. Okay. It's looking like the transition is not subtle enough, so I think I'm going to make that middle color a little bit lighter. But I love the top color. That's perfect. That's exactly what I'm going for. Let's share. Sorry. I have a habit of just bringing stuff really close to my face when I'm working on it, and it's not cool when I'm trying to share the process. That little corner right there. She's real filthy. Whoops. There we go. Let me move my body so I can see this. I totally missed the underside of that middle one. Good thing I'm repainting it. Fully missed that spot right there. Whoops. I listen to a lot of podcasts and constantly screaming at the show, like, the name of the Nick Cage movie is Ghost Rider. Even though I know they can't hear me. So know if you host a podcast, I'm talking to you. Talking to you from the comfort of my own home like we were friends. Like I said, I feel like that transition is not where I want it to be. So, getting there. That might be it. Maybe. What? Okay, it's just plastic. What chunk just flew out of the sky onto what I'm working on? I can't tell. It looks really close, but I'm gonna redo it anyway. It might just be that it's drying darker than I feel like it is, but that's not how I feel about that solid. Where's the one? Oh, there's the spot that I missed. I just said I missed the spot. This should be the easiest ombre in this project because it's two separate bottles of paint. So really, I just need to do, that's a color I just need to get an in-between. So like, you'd think 50-50, one of each. That's not how it's working out. Or maybe it is, and I'm just, like I said, bad at mixing paint. Can you even see this? No. Sorry. Okay. Less hateful. Yeah, I like that. A loot. So, let me just wipe off that color. Between ombres, I don't really wash my brush because I don't think it's super necessary. Get in that filthy little corner. Let's get that middle color situated. Can you see? I'm trying to have you see and also not dip the bottom of this in my pink gloves. There we go. Also try really hard not to get any on the white. I'm a shaky-handed person. Oh my god, and I just did. It looks okay. It's fine. Boom. Now, I do want a darker color for the underneath, so I'm going to mix it with the glob of regular blue. Or what is this? Two blue is what it's called. Let's see what happens. She's also, like, running into my workspace. It's really bothering me. There we go. It's doing something. Okay, okay, okay. We're getting there. Ooh, yeah, I like that. I think we're going to need a little bit more, though. Just going for it. Yo, 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 yo. Is it still too light? I think it's still too light. Yeah. Do I have to add black to it? I really don't want to do that. I tried to order gray paint also for this because I felt like that would be a lot easier than trying to add minuscule amounts of black. That's fine, actually. I think I got it there. And that did not show up. So yeah, I did all of this through, like, online grocery ordering. Oh, perf! Okay, good. I did good. And, so yeah, I'd order, red and get gloss red. Just like, okay, that's not what I ordered. Or, one of the worst was when I ordered white, and I guess they were out of white, which is weird because I know from the online ordering that there's like at least three different types of white acrylic paint, you know? And usually if I order something and they're out of it, we get like the name brand version. I'm cheap, but I never buy name brands. So for instance, God, what was it? Oh, was it ice cream? Or like, I don't know, something dumb, like Ziploc bags or something weird, but we got leveled up to the name brand because they were out of the generic. So you'd think that, oh, and we got a larger size once too because they were out of the smaller one, which was cool. We only got charged the smaller price. So again, you would think that they would just replace my white paint with another size of white paint, or again, maybe gloss instead of the one I asked for. No, they sent a tan. It was called Mocha, which I didn't hate, but white was like, I was really banking on that to get started with this project. And so that's why the pinks looked kind of weird. That's why I had to repaint the birds 3 times. Because I was trying to mix them a color with this weird purpley pink and mocha. No, it was not what I was thinking of. Not what I saw in my mind's eye. So yeah, that's been fun. So I think I had to make 2 orders of paint to get kind of what I needed. And in the second order, after they didn't send white, I was like, okay, let me order 1 of each white. And at least all the ones that they were in stock on. And I'm bound to get at least 1 bottle, and I did. I got 3 bottles of white now, so I'm getting cool on that. But yeah, that's how I ended up with that weird kind of purpley pink. Again, online shopping for colors is pretty tricky. I knew this when I worked at a craft store, and we had an online shop. It was a small store, or small company, I should say, and the online shop was run out of the store that I worked at, the location that I worked at. So I helped him out every now and then, or would pack orders, or just whatever. And every now and then, someone would call and try to get us to describe like a color over the phone. Oh God, that was so hard to like use words to describe a color, especially when you know, you just don't know the person you're talking to, so you don't really know their baseline, like what their references might be, or I don't know. It just made it a little trickier. And then also the fact that, you know, they would be calling about these like metallic envelopes, and like they don't look very shiny. And I'm like, well, you're looking at them through a computer, so like, we did our best. Or whoever took, I don't know who took the pictures, but they really did try their best to like show you that gold metallic envelope. But it you know, I don't know what your monitor is set to. Trust me, they're shiny. They're glittery. Like, don't be afraid. But yeah, that threw a wrench in it too, because, I don't know, maybe their screen is calibrated wrong, and that's why it doesn't look gold to them. Or sometimes I've seen people describe things, and I'm like, what planet did you come from? That is not how I would have said that. But, you know, being a person is fascinating. Everyone is different. I talked about grimy corners. Ooh, that's one. That's sure one. Okay. I'm gonna plop my finger right into the wet paint. To stop soon because I'm definitely getting really shaky. That's not cool. That's not fun for art. Ooh, there we go. There's like a weird little air bubble in the mold right there. And just visually it looks funny. Yeah, since I'm doing this like fine detail roofing type thing, it's kind of tricky. Also kind of wanted to make those, but I think that's too many different colors. Too many different colors. Okay. So I'm at a good place to pause. So I'm gonna do that. Looking at it like, I kinda wanna paint these birds that color too. I'm actually gonna paint the birds the light blue color. I'll do this next time. Oh, wait, what about that roof? Yeah, okay. Let's do this little roof real quick. Oh my god, and the other roof. Shoot, okay. It's also getting kind of warm in this room. I don't know if you can tell, but this is natural light I'm working with. And it's touching me. Well, it's not touching me, but it's about to touch me. Again, being really careful not to plop my hand in some wet paint. That is something I'm super good at. I kind of got to be careful because that little bit, I want to keep background color. Ooh, we're going to need a smaller boat. Oh my god, do you see me shake? That's why, oh my god. I don't do this for a living anymore. There we go. Whoo! That deserves a potato. I did that. Wow. Okay. When I woke up this morning, my left hand was really shaky, but I don't use that hand, you know? Shmanan damn it. So I wasn't too concerned about it. And I just got really concerned for a second there. Like, what is going on? The right hand's still a little bit too shaky for my liking. So again, I have to take a little break. At least get this tiny roof done. Anyone still watching? Yes, thank you, one person. It's been a whole hour. I really appreciate you. Thanks for watching. I hope this is soothing to you, as it is to me to watch other people just do art. Sorry, I keep flipping it out of the way so I can see my paint. Oh yeah, oh yeah, okay, there we go. This is gonna definitely need a second coat, but that's okay. It's kind of nice to just have these first coats down so I know what colors I'm gonna make everything. I have a plan. I'm just really good at forgetting the plan. You see that? Is it all right? Okay. Getting in here. Ooh, yes. Ooh, yes. Okay. Hey. Hi. Being really fussy around this flower, but As you can see, it needs a color, so I don't really need to do that. Just like cram my brush in there. But I don't want to mess up those green bits. I did kind of work on those, even though on drying they're looking a little patchy. They're gonna need some help. You know, I said one friend was moving away. Around three, actually. Forgot about that. One just left, and I'm sad to see her go. We have another friend. Well, her whole family is moving.
Everyone's moving east.
Good for them. All right, I think I'm gonna do. About making these orange. I still think actually I might. I don't like that contrast. Whoops. Well, I did it, so let's do the whole thing. Maybe I'll like it when the whole thing is done. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that orange. I mean, I don't hate it, but I almost feel like it would look better on that one, even though that's the one I plan on painting an orange roof on. Very concerned. One thing I do know that I want to do though is this. Can you see what I'm working on? What are you working on, Maze? There we go. I don't hate that. I need to like log this brush up. There we go. Oh, I feel like I just really screwed that up. Trying to get the edge of this window bit. I feel like I just blobbed way too much on. It's also like just a really weird perspective. Eh, it's not so bad. Definitely gonna have to put something going on inside of there though. And then there we go. Can you see that? No, it's sideways now, but that's helpful to me. Should I deal with it? know I said I don't like this, but still doesn't mean I want it unfinished. There we go. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna take off that little blue stick. I'm not into that. Let me get this one last bit. Yay! Okay. I think we're good for now. So yeah, my shaky ass is gonna take a break. Thanks for tuning in. Next time I wanna do the orange bits. So that's gonna be these flowers and that roof. And those little nubbins. Probably that fence is gonna be like orangey red color. Yeah. I don't have any yellow going on. So actually the fence might be yellow. Things in it. Yeah, like yellow, orange, yellow doodads. Okay, I'm getting there. We're getting there. Thumbs up, right? That was a really weird thumbs up. That's a good thumbs up. That's still a weird thumbs up. Anyway, thanks for joining. Preesh. I'll probably keep, I'm definitely going to keep working on this. Whether I do it on stream or not, we'll see. But yeah, thanks for hanging out in my dining room with me. Bye.